Well, I was kind of on the fence about buying another machine and what to get, so on and so forth. I had the Polaris Sportsman 500 for about 5 years, and that worked really well for what I wanted it for. But, you know, when I went hunting up in the mountains, I had to hook a trailer on it and carry out the game and stuff. And, I mean, it worked well. I really wanted something with a dump body. And a bench seat is nice if you'd ride in two people. I hated riding two people on an ATV. I never got comfortable with that. Unless you get into the bigger machines with the bigger seats and stuff that are made for two people. But I'm just not kind of really into that sort of thing. So I ended up settling on, or not settling, but I decided on this Ranger 500. And I gotta say, I'm pretty impressed with it. It's a base machine. I mean, it's nothing fancy. I think the retail on it's about $8,900, which is pretty modest for what you pay for these things nowadays. But, you know, and it's with no options. I can, you know, the open cab and all that. I can get the roof for it. And, you know, you can buy, I can't believe the accessories you can actually get for this thing. They've got windshields, doors with windows, roofs, back windows, gun racks, all sorts of agriculture additions, York rakes, all kinds of stuff. It's a really, really, really good universal working machine. I bought it primarily for, you know, working firewood, you know, hauling a little bit of firewood or campwood, I should say. Getting out there and getting, you know, when we harvest our, you know, bear or whatever, you can get out there and get it back with this, because we hunt where we hunt, we're allowed to use ATVs, so. And it's a couple of miles up where we go, so if you don't have an ATV, you don't get up there as much as you should. Like I said, I'm pretty happy with it. I'm always on the fence about doing, you know, reviews or impressions, I guess, whatever you want to call it, first impressions, because everybody's got something negative to say. But basically, if you're interested in a Polaris Ranger 4x4, that's kind of what this is intended for. Of course, it's got its safety features. You know, you can't start it. It won't start until you hit your... put your foot on the brake. Fires right up. Now you can see the, it's got a nice little tailgate on the dump body. You can drop that down if you want. And right now I got my box in there just because of what I'm doing. I'm out scouting. So, you know, I can carry stuff in there. There's all kinds of tire options for this thing as well. Different rims, different tire options. Back side panels. Great little machine, to be honest with you. I'm pretty happy, pretty impressed with it so far. Hood pops right up. Here we got our radiator and front end suspension, axle, so forth. Not much to see under there other than the radiator and a front axle. So you come in here and you can use this for storage. That's the gas tank right there. You can use this for storage. They have a little plastic insert that goes in there that's kind of expensive. You can just throw in some sort of plastic Rubbermaid or something and do pretty much accomplish the same thing. But you get some dry storage down in there in some fashion. It does come with a part of a battery tender. They give you the lead, but you need the expensive part, of course. And if you lift up the body, There's the motor, all nice and tucked away. The air box is in the back there. I guess you can get snorkel kits for it and so on and so forth. It's pretty slick. You know, it's just an all-around pretty handy little rig for hunting, scouting, fishing, working. Whatever you want to use it for. I'm not sorry I bought it. You know, sometimes when you buy something, I'd never owned a UTV. And it's like anything, you know, when you buy something for the first time, you're like, is it, you know, good idea, bad idea? And I'll tell you, from the time I loaded this onto the trailer and took it for a ride, I have not one bit of regret about buying this. This thing is exactly what I wanted it to be. Very simple, inexpensive, functional, and just really happy with it. And I'm going to do a few chores with it. Got to get some campfire wood over to the campfire ring so we can have a fire later. Do a little more scouting. There's a brook up there, actually. I might try a little bit of fishing. Two thumbs up for right now.
I'd also like to mention, I bought this at HK Power Sports over at Hooksett, New Hampshire. Had a really good, very positive experience with Hank, my salesman, who talked to him on the phone. Very easy to deal with over the phone. Got me all set up. I drove over there. Everything was ready. You know, had a great experience. Honest guy, which is, I don't usually throw people's names around unless I've had good experience. And I highly recommend going over there and checking out, see what they have. If you're interested, if you live in the area. And I asked for Hank. Great guy. Great experience. Can't say enough about him. The dealership overall, I was pretty impressed. So I did want to throw that out there.
Shut it down, you just, it's spring loaded, so it works pretty slick. Dumping out some loom or loading loom, whatever, I actually gotta load it up. So yeah, I really just can't say enough about it. I mean, some of the basics. It is 500cc, 32 horsepower. The front is McPherson strut, which seemed to handle pretty good. The back is what they call, I think, A-frame or whatever they call it. It is. It has 10 inches of ground clearance, which is pretty cool. I mean, that's enough to get you around most anything, or up over anything, I should say. The drive system is pretty cool. It's true all-wheel drive, as I mentioned.
It has four-wheel drive, two-wheel drive, and one-wheel drive, which I guess they call it turf saver. Well, you put it in one-wheel drive, and when you're driving across grass or loose gravel, it doesn't tear up the grass or make loose gravel or whatever, which is always kind of an issue with these things. You know, you're always looking back, and you realize you're really churning up the ground pretty bad, especially if you're trying to drive across the lawn. But with that turf mode, it eliminates that, which is huge, I think, on a, you know, utilitarian type machine that you're going to use around the house or the farm.